Not always filled with romantic adventures, the cowboy's life was often a battle for survival. Strength was his greatest asset, and often this alone determined his success or failure. Among the many tests of his abilities was the task of breaking and training the wild broncs that later became farm and saddle horses. Such a wild one was Strawberry Roan. I was hanging around town, just spending my time. I was out of the job and not earning a dime. When a feller steps up and he says, I suppose you're a bronc rider by the looks of your clothes. Well, I tells him I am a good one, I claim. Have you got any broncos you want me to tame? Then he says he's got one that's a bad one to buck, and at throwing top riders he's had lots of luck. Then I gets all excited and ask what he pays for to ride this old buckskin a couple of days. And he offered me 10, and I says, I'm your guy, for there's no bronc alive this old cowhand can't ride. So he says, get your saddle, I'll give you a chance. Then I gets in his buckboard, we drives to the ranch, and I stays until morning, and right after chuck I goes out just to see if this old nag could buck. Down there in the corral, a-standing alone, was this tough old horse flesh called Strawberry Roan. So I tightens my spurs and I climbs on his back, and he jumps and he snorts and starts bawling the jack. Then he bowed his old neck, gave a jump and unwound, and he seemed to quit living down here on the ground. He's about the worst bucker I've seen on the range. He can turn on a nickel and give you some change. I have rode him from Texas on up to Montana. I have broke the worst broncos in all of this land. But when he left the ground and he gave a big sigh, he only lacked wings to be able to fly. Then he turned on his old belly right up to the sun, for he sure was a rip-snorting son of a gun. And I'll bet all my dough, everything that I own, there's no man alive can ride Strawberry.